Very much. Let's go straight across now to Mr. Jain Gupta as well as Amit Tandon to discuss the consent order that's coming from the market regulator SEBI. This pertains, of course, to that almost decade-long Satyam matter, which now finds some degree of closure. Mr. Gupta, thanks very much. Let me start by asking you, sir, what do you make of the consent order that's coming from SEBI, barring PwC for a period of 2 years from conducting any audit-related activities for any listed securities? Some would argue that perhaps this is too little, too late.
I would not say it is too little, too late, because you know, in our judicial system, first the time is taken in everything, and secondly, it is a when you take action against big people, generally you think twice or thrice, which I don't think should be there, but this is what is affected. And secondly, in this, there is a history of litigation, Bombay High Court, Supreme Court, the Honorable Set and everything.
Sorry.
Now, coming to this order, first of all, it is very clear, and I would say that what SEBI has done is correct, because in entire system, auditors are supposed to be the first watchdog and protector of investors' interest and all other stakeholders' interest. And when they fail,
yes,
they cause a lot more damage to the system than anyone else. And I would say in Indian market, the biggest risk comes from the confidence or lack of confidence that investors have in the financial numbers that are given to them. And auditors are to be blamed. And we have been bringing out in the last 5-6 years the instances where auditors have failed. And this is going to be a test case and it is going to be a big case. And technically speaking, this is not a 2-year ban. If you look into the company that where the appointment of auditor is for minimum 5 years or the for a period of fixed period of 5 years, now this ban would be anywhere between 2 to 5 years, because nobody will be able to be appointed as auditor for 2 years. So it will be anywhere between 2 to 5 years,
right,
depending upon the company there.
2 to 5 years. Okay. Amit, let me take that point across to you. As Mr. Gupta is pointing out, that this will perhaps act as a deterrent, this will perhaps send out the message that audit-related activities need to be taken much more seriously. I mean, if you look at the details of this 108-page order, PwC did not check the veracity of Satyam's bank balance statements. They did not carry out reconciliation between Satyam's invoices to detect mismatch, did not verify TDS certificates. I mean, it's a long list of lapses that SEBI has pointed out in this over 100-page order. Do you believe that in light of this, this could act as a test case, as a deterrent for the audit community in general?
Shereen, you're absolutely right. But I have to say one thing. When I look at kind of what has happened over the last few years, including the SEBI order, I think what we are seeing is muddled thinking all across. You've got muddled thinking with the regulators, you've had muddled thinking with the corporate India, you've got muddled thinking with Price Waterhouse. Let me begin with Price Waterhouse. As you yourself have just said, there were serious lapses in terms of the process which were there at the end of PwC. Yet rather than kind of say that, look, there were a few bad apples, we kind of screwed up on this one, pardon my language. They're kind of at each stage, they've been kind of going to court and appealing and saying, look, this is not the right judgment and so on and so forth. And while they say that, they've kind of been going around and strengthening their processes, realizing there is a problem. If they kind of said that, look, this didn't work the way we wanted, we've got checks and balances, maybe they would have seen a different outcome today. If you look at corporate India, we've just gone through auditor rotation. And we looked at it, about 47 of the 700 companies we track have got Pricewaterhouse as their auditor. Now, they've kind of second-guessed that, you know, there's this investigation on, and no one or the regulators will not find any wrongdoing by PwC, so let's happily go ahead and appoint them. Now they're kind of scrambling to say that, look, having appointed someone for 5 years, how do you make this change? Finally, if you look at the regulators themselves, they should have actually said that, look, we're going to have punitive fine on the firm. And rather than then say that, look, we've kind of got companies in a situation where they've got an auditor, they need to move them out, reappoint them. And mind you, if the auditor is not good enough for 2019 and 20, how is it that I can rely on their audit in 2018?
Yeah.
So it's, I would say that this is just showing that there is a muddled thinking across all levels.
Okay, that's an interesting point that you make. And let me get Jayan Gupta, the former ED at SEBI, to respond. Jayan Gupta, the point that Amit Tandon makes is perhaps some would argue valid. What happens now? The fact that corporate India will be in this scramble to try and get auditors to replace PwC midway, the practical reality, and also, as Amit was pointing out, I mean, what will instill confidence? If you're not good enough for the next 2 years, then what makes you think that you'll be good enough for the next five?
Okay, Shereen, first of all, the order never says, or nowhere it says, that it should be done midway. The order very clearly says that the PwC will be allowed to finish their audit for the current year. So that means there will be no scramble for change of auditor. It will be only happening only after the year end. That is one. The second, if that is the logic, that if they are not good today, they will not be good after 2 years, that means for any crime, the punishment has to be lifelong. Because if today I was convicted in a court, or somebody is convicted in a court for 2 years, then why not lifetime? Because he will be never be good. The issue is that it is a deterrent. It is a signal for everybody, including PwC, that please reform yourself. And if you look at the order very clearly, it tells you a very simple thing. Although it may look that in the posterity, everybody is intelligent, but it is not the case. The audit process is such that if they had kept their eyes and ears open, they could have checked it. Because when the fictitious invoices were created, they were not in the same serial number as all other invoices. The first question I, as an auditor, would have asked you, why it is so different that these... And then you find that all these invoices are paid by check deposited into account somewhere, and this check amount is almost equal to the fixed deposit that are accumulating every year, then you will be very clear that this is a fraud. So the issue is that this gives, the 2 years will give time to PwC to put their house in order, make systems connect.
Well, a process which PwC itself says that they've put checks and balances in place after the Satyam scam came to light. But let me bring my colleague Yash, who's of course been studying this order very carefully, to ask you one final question. Yash, go ahead.
Thank you, Mr. Gupta and Mr. Tandon, for joining us. This is Yash. My question to you is on the larger issue of consent application. If you look at PwC, it's of course an auditing company, it's an auditing consultancy. Here, do you think the route of consent application should be shut for institutions which come with a larger fiduciary duty, like exchanges, like auditing companies? Because of course, they are responsible towards banks, they are responsible towards shareholders. Do you think consent application should be kept shut, that particular route should be kept shut for institutions like exchanges or auditing companies for that matter?
See, you are asking a very larger question, but I will respond. First of all, I am of the opinion that consent only has to be done in cases which are minor, which does not impact the system at large. And if you see the consent circular, it very clearly says that if there are issues, or if there is a crime which has been committed, which has a market-wide repercussion, it will not be done. Now, in case of auditors, if it is a case of an individual auditor, there could be a situation. But if it is a case of auditors like PwC or any other Big Four, then the issue is that if you feel that the system across the any audit organization is bad, then consent mechanism should not be there. That is one. And most of the time, the consent people go to avoid the lengthy legal process. And I would say that if the legal process itself is shortened, then consent will not be required. Because then either you're a bad man or you're a good man can be decided by the law very fast. So the issue is that cut down the time of process.
Okay. Amit, a final say on that question to you.
Yeah, I agree with pretty much what Mr. Gupta said on this. But on the other, I kind of don't find myself in agreement with him. My view is that, look, if you're saying that they're not good enough to audit in 19 and 20, then how is it that they're good enough now? As an investor, do I have any confidence? So either SEBI is convinced that PwC is good, has the ability to audit, and which is why they're letting them audit in FY18. If they're not good enough for 19 and 20, how is it that they're good enough this year? So clearly that order is not consistent with itself.
Okay, so some agreement and some disagreement on this panel.